everybody, and welcome back to the main event. Now, Teddy, coming up, a very unique opportunity for the TaylorMade Man. He is currently ranked number 10 in the WCW Heavyweight Championship rankings, and it's going to be an opportunity for him to meet Ravishing Rick Rude, the number one contender. Now, the winner of this match will go on in this top 10 challenge, and eventually someone is going to face the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion Sting for that coveted crown.
Well, the thing that concerns me is the TaylorMade Man meeting Ravishing Rick Rude. You know, both of these guys are supposedly to be on the same side. You would think that Terry Taylor, you know, has scored a seller with the Freebirds along with him and Greg Valentine. You know, they're no longer the United States Tag Team Champions. So now he steps in the ring with Ravishing Rick Rude. So you wonder, you know, what's going to happen in this match? You know, will somebody with the tempers flare? Will frustrations get in the way? We just don't know what might happen. Maybe Taylor's trying to become a member of the Danger Alliance. Who knows?
Who knows? I know one thing. Money talks and everything else walks.
You're
and
right.
This is Terry Taylor's opportunity to get a shot at the World's Heavyweight Championship. Let's get down to the ring. See the TaylorMade Man and Ravishing Rick Rude.
What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat, out of shape, snaggle-tooth sleaze bags, keep the noise down while I take my robe off and show you what a real sexy man is supposed to look like. Hit the music.
Well, Eric Bischoff, could you just run down the ringside right quick, pull your coat off, and show up what a real sexy man looks like? Could you do that for me, Eric?
I don't think so. What does he mean? Snaggletooth?
Well, I don't know. One thing I got to admire Rick Rude for, he changed ring partners there. I'd much rather have Medusa walking me to ringside than Paulie Dangerously.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, he is the number 10 contender for the world title. He is from Vero Beach, Florida. He weighs 236 pounds. The TaylorMade Man.
Well, here we go. Eric Bischoff, the godfather of Teddy Long, back on the main event. And when you take a look at the TaylorMade Man and Ravishing Rick Rude getting ready to do battle, it kind of concerns me. Both of these guys are rule breakers, supposedly to like each other, so I wonder what's going to come out of this match, Eric.
Well, we'll find out in the moments to come. And Denny, not too long ago, you mentioned the fact that the war between Ravishing Rick Rude and Ricky Steamboat is anything but over, and you are absolutely right. And coming up June 20th, part of Beach Blast, WCW promoters have signed Ravishing Rick Rude and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat to a 30-minute Iron Man challenge. Here's how it works. There's going to be a score clock set for 30 minutes.
All right.
The wrestler with the most decisions during that 30-minute time limit is declared the winner of the Iron Man Challenge. And Teddy, this is going to be a test of will as well as physical endurance.
Well, you know, whenever you go into a deal where you've got Ravishing Rick Rude facing Ricky Steamboat, you've got to always remember the humiliation that Ricky Steamboat received from Rick Rude. How he had to face his kid, his wife, with a broken cheekbone. A lot of humiliation. So whenever these two men meet, not only are the U.S. title at stake, but their careers both are on the line, because I'm guaranteeing you that both of these guys may take each other out on any given night.
Ravishing Rick Rude now doing his best to take the TaylorMade Man out. Sets up for a back body drop. First clothesline by the TaylorMade Man. However, referee position's got a two count. Nice five play takedown by the TaylorMade Man. Goes into an armbar. Tremendous amount of pressure on that elbow and the rotary cuff of the shoulder. Ravishing Rick Rude now up on both knees.
Well, you know, it seems to me, Eric, there may be a mystery going on right here. You know, the TaylorMade Man and Valentine, they're no longer the United States Tag Team Champions. The Freebirds hold those titles now. And then you look at Taylor now, He's out here wrestling Ravishing Rick Rude. You wonder, you know, what's on his mind. There has to be a mystery to this.
Well, it's no mystery that the TaylorMade Man wants to move up in the rankings and wants a shot at the World Tag Team title, and certainly this match, this top 10 match, will give him an opportunity.
Well,
you definitely move up in the rankings.
Well, you also know, Eric, if he can get a win today on national TV against Rick Rude, the United States champion, it also puts him in line as one of the contenders for the United States heavyweight title.
TaylorMade Man now really cranking on the wrist as Ravishing Rick Rude gets a hold of that rope, forces the referee to call for the break. TaylorMade Man out of the boot to the floating rib area. Ravishing Rick Rude outside of the ring, and he tremendous amount of pain catches the left leg of the TaylorMade Man and wraps it around the ring post.
You gotta watch a guy like Ravishing Rick Rude. You know, he was outside. You know, I call it playing possum. TaylorMade Man went for it, got too close to the rope. Rude snatched him right out. Now he's working right on that injured leg.
Back leg round kick to the hamstring area will definitely take that leg out from underneath you. That is exactly what Ravishing Rick Rude is doing right now. Tremendous amount of velocity in those kicks. He's using the arch of his foot.
Well, you know, when you leg, you know, that's definitely got to slow him down. If he has no legs, he can't walk.
You watch athletes like the great Muda, for example, who use a lot of back leg round kicks and karate style kicks in the ring. They'll use either the heel of the foot or they use that, the arch of the foot, the instep. Hard as a rock. And now Ravishing Rick Rude going to work again on the hamstring area after raking the eyes of the TaylorMade Man.
Now, what an outstanding contest this is. Now, both these guys, you know they have to get each other. There's a neck breaker from Ravishing Rick Rude. Now he goes for the cutter. Referee's down two. Wow.
2.5. Kick out by the TaylorMade Man, who's showing some signs of exhaustion here. Makes his way up. Certainly that leg giving him some trouble. Big right hand from Ravishing Rick Rude. Cutter by Taylor. Fist. Going on inside of the center of the ring now.
Well, you've got to understand. Wow, poke right in the eyes from the TaylorMade Man. Now, Barry, what you got to understand is one thing. The TaylorMade Man don't want no more losses. He just lost the United States Tag Team Championship. That's what he needs real bad. But wait a minute.
Rode in position, hooks the leg, and that's it.
Gentlemen, here's your winner.
Taylor gives him that neck breaker or the rude awakening or whatever you want to call it. Covers him for the 1, 2, 3, and brother, we're going to go to the WCW magazine.